Hi everyone, it's Dr. Cleopatra Gordon-Pusey again with Life is Beautiful MD and Life is Beautiful Ministries. And in commemoration of Black History Month, I'm gonna sing a few songs by different artists. I'm gonna sing Lift Every Voice and Sing by James Weldon Johnson, and it's the Negro National Anthem. And I'm also gonna sing Andra Day, Rise Up. There's just so much going on, like it breaks my heart that, you know, last week we learned that Miss America, who was an African-American young lady, she took her own life. And again, I keep expressing to you all that the reason why I'm doing this channel is to prevent stuff like that. You know, I'm trying to lift people's spirit, lift people's awareness, let them know that God made us. We're fearfully and wonderfully made. Every hair on our head are numbered. God cares about us. And I know without a shadow of a doubt that if we all accept, if we accept God and his son Jesus that he sent on this earth to die for us, I know that Jesus is the only one that can give us the peace that passes all understanding. So all we have to do is just accept him in our hearts. We just have to open up our hearts and mind and ask God to lead us and guide us every day. We just have to follow the basic instruction before leaving earth. That's the B-I-B-L-E. That's the Holy Bible. It's the most read book in this entire world. It has the blueprint about how we're supposed to live on this earth so we could live a wonderful and awesome, faith-filled, happy, joyous life. So I encourage each and every one of you to, if you don't know the Lord, you have to try and just speak to him. He's there. God is everywhere. God is a spirit, and he said that they that worship him must worship him in spirit and in truth. He is everywhere. He made each and every one of us. He loves each and every one of us, and we just need to give our hearts to him and ask him to remove everything that is not of him from our heart and fill it up with him. And only he and he alone can give us that peace that passes all understanding. Jesus said in the New Testament that we should ask and it shall be given, seek and it shall be found, knock and it shall be opened unto us. In Psalm 139 verse 14, it says we are fearfully and we are wonderfully made. God knows everything about us. God knew us before we were formed in our mother's womb. And we need to just give our hearts, our minds, our body, our souls, or everything to God. Put everything to God and he will take us through. He loves us. He cares about us. Back in the New Testament, when Jesus came, there was a lady that was caught in the act of adultery. And back in the days, if you're caught in such an act, they usually stone you to death. And then Jesus was standing in like a public area. And a lot of people, he heard a commotion and a lot of people came and they were ready to, you know, stone this woman to death. And Jesus said to them, you know, he started writing on the ground. And he said, just for example, he says like Tom sin, Sam sin, Sarah sin, Pam sin, just different names. He just started writing names in the underground that this person has sinned and this person has sinned and this person has sinned and this person has sinned. And then Jesus said, he who is without sin, cast the first stone. And by the time he said that, there was nobody left in the area, just Jesus and this lady that was caught in the act of adultery. And Jesus said to the lady, woman, like who has, is there anyone here that has condemned you? He said, no one has condemned you. So go your way and sin no more. Go your way and sin no more. That's just one woman caught in the act of adultery. And that's what Jesus did for her. He told her to go her way and sin no more. And that's the beauty of God and him loving so much that he sent Jesus to die for us, that no matter what we do, you know, all we have to do is earnestly repent of our sins and ask God for forgiveness, and he will forgive us. And we just continue to ask him each and every day to come into our hearts, to order our steps, to order our thoughts, to order our talk, to order our walk, to order everything we say and do, and let it be holy and acceptable unto him. Because only he and he alone gives life, and only he and he alone can take life. But there's so much going on, and a lot of people are taking things into their own hands. But we just have to put our hearts, our mind, our body, our soul, everything, and give it to Jesus. Yesterday, I had an opportunity to go to my daughter's high school to speak to their group, Women of Tomorrow, and it was about 30-plus young ladies. And believe me, there was all different race, color, creed, religion there. But I told them the secret of my success. The secret of my success is St. Matthew 6, verse 33. Seek ye first the kingdom of God and all his righteousness, and everything else will be added unto me. You know, and everything else will be added unto you. Seek ye first the kingdom of God and all his righteousness, and everything else will be added unto you. God has given me everything I need. I'm not a fussy person. I don't ask for too much. I tell my husband every day. I tell my children every day. I'm very easily satisfied. There's a roof up above me. You know, there's shoes on my feet. There's food on my table. I'm healthy. I'm whole. I'm well. I'm not in a hospital. There's just so much going on that we take for granted. But God is an awesome God, and he loves us, and he cares about us. And sometimes the things that we think we need, we don't need. We just need simple things like oxygen. The fact that I'm standing here and I'm breathing, I'm moving, I'm standing, I'm not laid up in a bed, I'm not crippled. You understand? The same thing with you. You're well, you're whole. And even if any of the things that I'm describing you have, you're still alive and you're still well. And God loves you and cares about you. And all you have to do is to give your heart, your mind, your body, your soul to him. And he will make you well, and he will make you whole, and he will give you joy, and he will give you the peace that passes all understanding. I'm just asking you to just be blessed and be safe, and just, no matter what it is that you're going through, no matter what it is you're going through, turn it over to Jesus. Turn it over to Jesus, and everything will be all right, okay? Everything will be all right. Turn it over to Jesus, and everything will be all right. I'm going to just sing a few songs, and I just hope these songs bless you, and may God receive all the glory. And the goal of this YouTube channel, Instagram, Facebook, everywhere this is being seen, my goal is to change the world one life at a time. So I'm asking you to share with your friends, to share with your family, spread the love and the joy, and let them know that Jesus loves you, God loves you, and you who are sending it to somebody else, you love that person too, and that's why you're lifting them up. I love you, and that's why I'm here sharing the love and the joy and trying to give you a part of that peace that passes all of understanding that I have. Because I know without a shadow of a doubt, it's not my money, it's not my car, it's not my business, it's not my children, it's not my husband, it's not my family that is making me happy. It's God that gives me the peace that passes all understanding. I try every day to communicate as much as I can, as I walk, as I drive, as I take care of the patients, as I do this video with you. I ask him to give me what to say to you to bless you. Just put God first in all you do, and believe me, he and only he can help you on this earth until he thinks your time is fit enough and for us to go meet him. So just be blessed and be safe and be covered under the blood of Jesus. I love you with the love of the Lord. Just enjoy these songs. And like I said, may you be blessed and may God receive all the glory. Amen. Amen.
Welcome into this place. Welcome into this broken vessel. You desire to abide in the praises of your people.
Sing to you, Lift Every Voice and Sing by James Weldon Johnson. And the first time, my first encounter with this song, I came to America in 1987 and I went to the eighth grade. The ninth grade, I went to high school and we had a lovely English teacher. Her name was Miss Moses. She asked us to, this Lift Every Voice and Sing is a poem, but obviously too, it's a hymn. So she asked us to recite the poem or the hymn, whichever one we wanted to do. And I went and I sang part of it and I recited the other part of it and I got an A plus from Miss Moses. So I'm gonna give you my rendition. The track is a little fast. I would have liked to sing it slower, but I'm gonna give you my rendition of Lift Every Voice and Sing. I hope you love it. And may we remember all our ancestors that have come and gone before us and have paved the way. Dr. Martin Luther King, Miss Rosa Parks, Mr. Nelson Mandela, there's so many. President Barack Obama, who came and became the first African-American president of the United States of America. There's so many others that have, Mr. Marcus Garvey from Jamaica, one of our national heroes, you know, Mr. Malcolm X. There's so many that have done so much for us. And even in modern day, Mr. Tyler Perry, Miss Oprah Winfrey, there's so many, you know, even the gospel artists, Mr. Kirk Franklin, Mr. Donnie McClurkin, Miss Tasha Cobbs, and even the movie stars, and, you know, Mr. Roger P. Hansen, Mr. Denzel Washington. There's so many of us that have done so many things, even the NFL players and the basketball players and the, you know, the track runners, Mr. Hussein Bolt from Jamaica. All of, you know, our ancestor came and paved the way for us to do better and be better. And we should just continue to do that and lift each other up. And I hope this song may just bless you and may God receive all the glory. Lift every voice and sing, Mr. James Weldon Johnson.
Lift every voice and sing, till the thick heaven ring, ring with the harmonies of liberty. Let our rejoicing rise high as the lifting skies. Let every sound loud as the rolling sea. Sing a song full of the faith that the dark path has taught us. Sing a song full of the hope that the present has brought.
Should have been slower, but I hope you enjoyed it. Be blessed and look up the word. Yes, that song was like a marathon. It was so fast. I wish it had been slower. I felt like I just ran a 400 meter or 800 meter. I ran track in high school and college. That was so funny. But any which way, the words are very powerful. So just go and look it up. You know, I sang part of it for my project when I was in high school, and I said the rest of it. Stony the road we trod, bitter the chastening rod, felt in the day when hope unborn I died. Yet with a steady beat, have not our weary feet come to the place for which our father sighed? We have come over a place that with tears had been watered. We have come threading a path through the blood of the slaughtered. Shadowed beneath thy hands, may we forever stand true to God, true to our native land. Thank you. Hope you enjoy that. Be blessed. Take care.
You're broken down and tired, living life on a merry-go-round. You can find the fight, but I see it in you, so we gon' walk it out and move mountains. We gon' walk it out and mountains. And I'll rise up, I'll rise like the day. I'll rise up, I'll rise unafraid. I'll rise. rise again. I'll rise up high like the waves. I'll rise up in spite of the hate. I'll rise up and I'll do it a thousand times again.
I'm
So yes, my friends, I thank you for coming along with me and watching this little Black History Month program in commemoration of February 2022, Black History Month. And I'm going to end this Black History Month program with one of my favorite songs, my tribute to God Be the Glory, because without him, I would be nothing. No money, no car, no husband, no wife, no children, no nothing in the world can give you the peace that passes all understanding. Only Jesus Christ can give you the peace that passes all understanding. And I'm going to end with my tribute. I hope you just enjoy this song and be blessed and give God all the honor and the glory. I know I give him all the honor and the glory for everything that he's done for me, for everything that he's doing, and for everything that he's going to do. So I'm going to leave you with this song. May God bless, keep you, and cover you. May he cause his face to shine upon you and be gracious unto you. May he lift up his light of his countenance upon you and give you his peace, even now and forevermore. Be blessed.
How can I say thanks for the things that you've done for me? Things so undeserved, yet you gave to prove your love for me in the voices. Oh,
This concludes our Black History mini concert. I trust that you enjoyed it as much as I had making it for you. These are just some pictures of myself and my students from Ross University School of Medicine that has come to do their 6 weeks rotation, and they have completed it. Dr. Martin Luther King Day just passed, and we'll never forget his I Have a Dream speech, because he put his life on the line. Myself, a young lady from Jamaica, was able to come to America and achieve the American dream. This is my family, Reverend Bramwell, and my three beautiful children. This is my four parents. My grandmother all took the time to raise me. My daughter, Kalia, in a Black History Month pageant. We thank you for watching. We hope that you enjoyed. Share and subscribe. More pictures with my students that have graduated their preceptorship program, nurse practitioners, daughters and mothers bonding. Dr. Gordon-Pusey, October for Breast Cancer Awareness Month. Dr. Gordon-Pusey, MD, at your service. My daughter in the military entrepreneurial program, both daughters doing well there. More students finishing up their preceptorship program and moving on from the family practice rotation they did at my office to other places. Mr. Tyler Perry and I celebrate the same birthday, and he's contributed so much to us. We thank you so much for watching. This is me with my Leading Physician of the World Award. Life is beautiful indeed. Keep on keeping on, and let's each of us, doesn't matter the race, the color, the creed, let's continue to lift each other up, because we're God's children and we're God's hand extended. A picture of my aunt Marjorie in the red. She's graduating there with her doctorate as a nurse practitioner. Aunt Nett and my sister, they're both nurses. This is me with my award. This is Aunt Nett and Aunt Doreen graduating as a nurse. This is my dad, who named me Cleopatra. This is myself and my daughter graduating from residency program. This is myself, that picture I was talking about, the husband and the wife, the baby with the MD degree, as I mentioned to you earlier. More students from different schools, St. George's, American University of the Caribbean, Ross University School of Medicine. And this is me again, third year of residency, graduating with two children and a husband. These are more students as they finish their preceptorship program. They've completed it at Life is Beautiful MD and going on to other rotation to complete their MD degrees. I thank God for the opportunity to teach them. This is us dressed up for Black History Month some years ago. More students again. Last but not least, I would like to thank my Life is Beautiful cast for their dire support. And without them, we could not have such a successful practice running. I cherish each one of you, and you're highly appreciated. Be blessed, be safe until we meet again. This is Dr. Cleopatra Gordon-Pusey with Life is Beautiful MD and Life is Beautiful Ministries. Take care. Bye-bye.